Hello everyone, my name is K. Vishnu. I'm dealing with a subject called as Power System Operation and Control. So in the last lecture we have seen that we are having different methods of steady state analysis, that is uncontrolled case and controlled case of steady state analysis. So in the uncontrolled case, what we have did, we have placed delta Pc is equal to 0, and in the controlled case we have assumed that delta Pd is equal to 0, that is nothing but the load change is equal to 0 in the controlled case. But whereas in this dynamic analysis of load frequency control, so in that we have considered the frequency, the change in the frequency is with respect to the time. As the time changes, the frequency is going to be changes, that we have seen. But whereas if we come for the next topic is, we are having integral control of single area system. So what do you mean by integral controller? So before going to third topic, we will see what is the learning objective of this lecture. So if you see that, to understand the control of single area system, to reduce the steady state error to 0. So to reduce the steady state error to 0, we are going to make the steady state error of the frequency to 0 by using integral controller. So that we will see in this lecture. So, to understand the load sharing of the parallel generators, we are going to connect the two generators in parallel. How the load is going to be shared between those two generators, we are going to explain in this lecture. The last one is to understand the control area concept. So, how the control area concept means, how the control area is going to be works, what are the control area in a power system. So, what is that concept? What is the area control error, is ACE, area control error. So that we are going to learn in this lecture. Right. So if we see the proportional plus integral control of single area system. So proportional plus integral controller means we are adding the integral controller to the single area system. So what do you mean by integral controller? What is the need? What is the need of integral controller means? So integral controller will reduce or makes the integral controller steady state error to 0. Steady state error in the frequency. So if I consider the steady state error in the frequency is nothing but delta F starting. Delta F starting is equal to 0. That means your steady state frequency error is going to be 0. Then there is no change in the frequency. Means we are maintaining the constant frequency. Then we are maintaining the constant speed. The power generated, that is active power generated output, is maintained as constant according to the load requirement. According to the load requirement, we are maintaining a constant power. So, as in the previous case, what happens is, whenever we are changing our speed changer setting according to the load requirement, whenever we are changing the speed changer setting according to the load requirement, there is a delta Pd is there. According to that delta Pd is nothing but load change. According to that load change, if we change the speed changer setting, that is delta Pc, at the starting you are going to have delta Pc of S. So I am changing the delta Pc according to the requirement of delta Pd, because the delta Pd is going to be the always changes. The load is always changes. According to that requirement, I am changing the speed changer setting, that is input power change command, that is delta Pc I am changing. That means, so for this change, you are having the large amount of the deviation in the speed. For small change in the power command, there is a large deviation in the speed as well as there is a large deviation in the frequency. So in order to, actually our Indian tolerance is for the frequency is plus or minus 3% as already I said. So that means you need to maintain the frequency in between 48.5 to 51.5. Within that limit you need to maintain. But whereas if you change the power change command according to the load requirement, then what happens here? Here means it is increases, means there is a large deviation in the speed that will cause to move the frequency above the tolerated value. So in order to avoid that, we are going to reduce, or we are going to make some steady state error of the frequency to 0 by introducing an integral controller. That is what here Ki by S. We are having a Ki by S signal, but there is an integral controller. Integral controller is a Ki by S. So let us consider As we know that kg kt is equal to 0, gain constant and time constant is equal to 0, sorry, k equal to 1, and there is a delta pc power change in command that is equal to, we are considering in the delta pc, at the place of delta pc we have considered, we have introduced an integral controller. That integral controller is nothing but ki by s, and there is a frequency sensor with a magnitude of 1. I have considered there is a frequency sensor with a magnitude of 1. Then if I take that delta pc is equal to, delta pc is equal to minus ki integration of delta f into d. Why I have considered delta f over there means for the change in the power command, for the change in the power command delta pc, you are having, there is a change, there is a change in the delta f. Delta f is nothing but your change in the frequency. By changing the power, by changing speed changer setting, this delta pc is going to be changes. Then what happens? That is in turn changes the frequency. So that's why I am considering integration of frequency. If I consider the integration of the frequency, that means that is going to be reduced to 0. That integral controller will make the steady state error to 0. Right? So by applying the Laplace transform for the delta pc equation, we are going to get delta pc of s. I am applying Laplace transform is delta pc of s, which is equal to minus ki by s into delta f of s. Minus ki by s is nothing but what? There is an integration. So if I convert that integration to the Laplace transform, you are going to get by s. That is 1 by s minus ki by into s into delta f of s. You are having the negative feedback. Right? There is a negative feedback, that means you are having minus in the equation. So, and for the step change of input in the load change, there is a delta pd. So for that delta pd, you are changing the step change. That means the load is always considered as a change which is in the stepwise. So let us take 2 megawatts, 4 megawatts, 6 megawatts, like that we are going to have change. So, and if I consider step change in the load, then delta pd of s is equal to minus delta pd by s. That input is minus input. If you see there, in the block diagram you are having minus, whereas in the delta pd you are having minus. That is nothing but what? Input is considered as minus. Delta pd of s is equal to minus delta pd by s you are going to have. So from the block diagram, if we write the transfer function equation, so what is the transfer function? Output by input. That is Laplace transform of output by Laplace transform of input. Laplace transform of output is nothing but delta f of s, and there is an input is nothing but delta pd here considered as an input, because we are applying the integral controller to the uncontrolled case. So whereas in the uncontrolled case we have kept delta pc is equal to 0, then we are considered that there is a load change, that is delta pd of s. So that is considered, that delta pd of s is considered as an input for us. So I am considering delta pd of s as an input, and there is a output is delta f of s. If I write the transfer function equation, output is equal to, that is delta f of s is equal to kp by, if you see that kp by 1 plus stp, kp by 1 plus stp as a block diagram. So that is what the block, that is the g of s block only. The remaining total thing is considered as a feedback. The remaining, all the blocks are considered as a feedback. The first one, that is kp by 1 plus stp block, is only considered as a g of s function, and the remaining all are considered as feedback. So if I write like that, if I write the equation, so here kp by 1 plus stp by 1 plus kp by 1 plus stp, that is g of s by 1 plus g of s into h of s. H of s is nothing but the total remaining blocks, that is 1 by r plus integral value, that is ki by s, and again you are having another block that is called as governor block as well as turbine block. So that is, I am considering here kg into kt is equal to 1. Then you are having in the numerator of that block equation, that is you are going to get 1 by 1 plus stg into 1 plus std you are going to get in the denominator of this equation. So if I take 1 by 1 plus stp in the denominator as a common, then you are going to get k kp by 1 plus stp by 1 plus stp plus kp by 1 plus stg into 1 plus stt into 1 by r plus ki by s you are going to get. Total divided by you are having 1 plus stp I have taken common. Right. So these 1 plus stp and that 1 plus stp both are gets cancelled. Then you are going to get delta f of s is equal to what? Minus kp by 1 plus stp plus kp by 1 plus stp. Sorry, is 1 plus stg into 1 plus stt into 1 by r plus ki by s you are going to get. There is an input call that is delta pd of s by s or delta pd by s you can consider. So just I am writing that delta pd by s in the starting of this equation minus delta pd by s kp by. So if I take rearranging the denominator terms by taking s and r as a common, then you are going to get s into 1 plus stg, 1 plus stt and 1 plus stp into r plus kp into 1 plus stt by s into 1 plus stg into 1 plus stp into r you are going to get. So if I write by, if I take that denominator term to the upper side, we are going to get the last equation, that is delta f of s is equal to minus delta pd by s into r into kp into s into 1 plus stg into 1 plus stt by 1 s into 1 plus stg into 1 plus stt into 1 plus stp into r plus kp into r ki plus s you are going to get. So that is what the final equation. So in that, if I apply the final value theorem, that is the last one, if I apply the final value theorem for that, then what happens? That means, what is the final value theorem? That is delta f static. Delta f static is a final value theorem. That is delta f static is equal to limit s tends to 0 s into delta f of s. I am substituting limit s tends to 0 s into delta s. That is delta f of s is nothing but what is your output equation. So in that, in the last equation you are having output, that is delta f of s. So that I am substituting in this equation. So that is delta f static is equal to limit s tends to 0 s into minus delta pd by s into r kp s into 1 plus stg into 1 plus stt by s into 1 plus stg 1 plus stt and 1 plus stp into plus kp into r into ki plus s you are going to get. So that is what the total equation. If I substitute s is equal to 0 in that equation, s is equal to 0 in that equation, you are going to get the equation which is below. That is delta f starting is equal to 0 because you are substituting s is equal to 0 in the numerator, s is equal to 0. Then there is a s in the numerator, then you are going to get the 0. Then numerator 0 is nothing but 0 by something is nothing but 0. You are going to get 0 by. Right. That is delta f static is equal to 0. You are making delta f static is nothing but change in the frequency. Change in the frequency is equal to maintained as 0 is nothing but there is no change in the frequency. That means there is no change in the speed. As we are maintaining there is no change in the speed means there is no change in the power output. That is power generated is maintained as constant. We are maintaining constant power, that means the output is constant. Our ultimate aim is to want to maintain the constant frequency to get the constant power output. That is steady state output needs to get. So that is going to be done with the help of integral controller. By adding the integral controller we can make steady state error to 0. That is what your integral controller, which makes very helpful in the controlling of power system. That is generator where you are having speed changer is available. Right. The next one is load sharing between the two synchronous machines which are in octave. So what if there are conditions are there? We need to satisfy the following three conditions in order to make your machines, that is generators connected to parallel. There are conditions. The following three conditions must be satisfied in order to connect the two machines in parallel. So if I consider the synchronous machines, So those synchronous machines must be connected in parallel in order to have the load sharing. So how to get that conditions means, what are the those three conditions are nothing but these three conditions. So if you see that, the first one is the terminal voltage of the machine must be equal to the bus bar voltage where you are connecting the other machine. You are having two machines. These two machines are connected to the bus bar. Then thus that bus bar voltage must be same as that of the generated machine voltage. That is the first one. The next one is, that is the second one is, the phase sequence of the voltages of the incoming machine. First one, you are connected some machine. There is a voltage for that, there is a phase sequence for that. And you have connected another machine. Whatever the machine which you are connecting is nothing but this incoming machine. The phase sequence of the voltages of the incoming machine must be same as that of the bus bar. Whatever the phase sequence is there for the bus bar, that is R, Y, V, if I consider the phase sequence, then the incoming machine, whichever you are connecting the other machine, that must be have the same phase sequence, that is R, Y, V. That must be same phase sequence as earlier. That is, earlier you have connected one machine, that is connected to the bus bar. Bus bar is having some phase sequence, that must be same as the other, right? The third one is, the frequency of the incoming machine should be equal to that of bus bars. The frequency of the incoming machines must be equal to that of bus bar. If bus bar is maintained 50 Hz frequency, then the incoming machine generated frequency must be 50 Hz only. So that only we can synchronize these two machines and we can run these two machines as a parallel. So if we see the circuit diagram for that, load sharing between the two synchronous machines is this one. So in that we are having two generators, that is E1 and E2. These two generates the EMFs as E1 and E2. We are having the impedance, there is a Z1 and Z2. We are having the currents in that generator is nothing but generator 1 generates the current of I1 and generator 2 generates the current of I2. Then there is a load which I have connected, that is Z is a load. There is a voltage. Voltage is common, that is the same voltage is there, because we are operating the generators in parallel, means you are having the same voltage. You are having the same voltage, right? So if you solve the equations for that, then you are having, so here if I see E1 and there is a I1 into Z1, if I apply KVL over there, then what happens means, that is first equation, E1 minus I1 Z1 is equal to V. Here I have the terminal voltage is V, E1 minus I1 Z1 is equal to V. Then next equation is E2 minus I2 Z2 is equal to V. Then we are having, there is a load. So if you see there is a load is there, that is Z, and there is a total current of I which is flowing through the Z, and there is a voltage V. So if I write voltage equation for that load, V is equal to I into Z we are going to get. So if I substitute, I is equal to what? So if we see that equation, sorry, that diagram, so in that we are having I is equal to, there are two currents are entering there, I1 plus I2 is equal to I. So if I substitute I1 plus I2 in that place of I, we are going to get I1 plus I2 into Z. That means I1 plus I2 is equal to what? V by Z I can write. 1 by Z is nothing but, it is a reciprocal of impedance, that is nothing but the what? Admittance, V into Y. V into Y is nothing but, there is a Y is nothing but admittance, V into Y, that is the equation 3. So if I take the equation 1, so in that let us take the I1 value. So I1 means E1 minus V by Z1, that means 1 by Z1 is there, right? If I take that as admittance, then you are going to get multiplied by Y1. E1 minus V into Y1. Then you are having I2. I2 equation is nothing but what? I2 is equal to E2 minus V by Z2. Then E2 minus V into Y2. Then you are having I1 plus I2. Just add these two equations, I1 equation and I2 equation. That is E1 minus V into Y1 plus E2 minus V into Y2 you are going to get. But we know that from the equation 3, I1 plus I2 is equal to what? V into Y. Then V into Y is equal to, just add the two equation, that is e1 minus b into y1 plus e2 minus b into y2. Then you are going to get, if you solve those equations, you are going to get v is equal to e1 y1 plus e2 y2 by y1 plus y2 plus y. You are going to get. So there is a load sharing between the generators, means for the first generator, if I consider the load shared by the generator 1 is v1 is equal to e1 y1 by y plus y1 plus y2. You are going to get load sharing between the two generators, that is load shared by the generator 2 is v2 is equal to e2 y2 by y plus y1 plus y2. So if we see the, there is an area control error. What do you mean by area control error? Area control error is nothing but the signal which is fed to the integrator as a form of frequency. As a form of frequency, that is nothing but there is a frequency sensor is there, which I considered as one magnitude. So that through that frequency sensor, whatever the input which are fed to the integral controller, that is nothing but delta f. That delta f is considered as area control error, ACE, right? So if you see the summary of this lecture is, so in this what we have did is, we have used integral controller. That integral controller to make the steady state error to zero. That we have done, delta f static is equal to zero. So this will help in the controlling of real time power system in order to maintain the constant frequency. So then we are having the three conditions to share the load between the two generators which are operating parallel. Those three conditions must be satisfied. Then only you can able to connect the machines into the parallel operation. And in this, we are analyzing single area system. So this single area system analysis will help you to understand the two area system analysis. By adding the two single areas, then we are adding a total two area system. So that is the total summary of this lecture. And thank you. Thank you everyone for listening.